Democrats are split on Joe Biden's handling of the Israel-Hamas war. John, you know I look at poll numbers a lot. For a president to be doing this poorly amongst his own party on any issue is quite something to see.
And perhaps that's the reason why President Joe Biden had allegedly a tense conversation with Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu today. We will get to those details in just a moment. But first, a new general election poll by the Wall Street Journal does spell trouble for Joe Biden in critical swing states, with Trump basically leading in every single one except for Wisconsin. Further bad news for Biden is the fact that these are the results, even with RFK Jr., who is skimming votes from Donald Trump, included in the race. And as you heard, Biden's handling of the Israel-Hamas war has a lot to do with him flailing in the polls among Democratic voters and independents who lean Democratic. Let's watch.
So this is approval among Democrats on Biden's handling of a lot of different issues here. The economy, Russia, Ukraine, pretty good, right? 81%. Jump down to foreign policy, you see this drop to 65%. Gun violence, 60%. US-Mexico border, 58%. These are not good numbers for a Democrat amongst his own party. But look here, the Israel-Hamas war, look at that approval rating. Less than 50% of Democrats are approving on Joe Biden, on the Israel-Hamas war. And more than that, John, these numbers have gotten significantly worse. So this is Democrats' views of Biden on the Israel-Hamas war. Look back in October of 2023, it was 67%. Look where we are today, 48%. That disapproved number, look at that, jumped up from 28% in October of 2023 to 46% now. This is within the margin of error. Democrats are split on Joe Biden's handling of the Israel-Hamas war. John, you know I look at poll numbers a lot. For a president to be doing this poorly amongst his own party on any issue is quite something to see.
Now, we have more from this poll, just a moment on that. But Cenk, I feel like you and I have predicted that this would hurt Biden and his chances of getting reelected almost immediately after Israel started bombing Gaza, right? We knew that it was very likely that the far-right government of Israel was going to take it too far, that Democratic voters weren't going to like it. It's just that Biden has taken, well, he hasn't really pivoted at all, but to really address or release statements about how brutal this war has been toward Palestinian civilians, it has taken him a while to even say anything about that.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth, as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you. Yeah, so I wanna tell you guys why we've been right all along and what the difference maker is between us and mainstream media, etc. But I also wanna tell you something we got that I did not expect and I'm now seeing, okay? So. Look, we are on social media, digital media, etc. We're on almost every platform. So we are better connected to the grassroots, to the base, to the actual human beings, voters, and especially the young people, right? So their discontent with this was super obvious to anyone that didn't live in Washington. But you have to remember, Washington is an island. And in that island, they think almost the exact opposite of what everyone else in the country thinks, and they all think it. So it's very, very hard for them to understand simple concepts. And we told them that, well, of course, I mean, if you support a bloody war where tens of thousands of civilians have been massacred, yeah, young people are generally not going to like that, let alone other parts of your Democratic base. But to them, no, it's a very simple formula. If you're a politician, let alone a Democrat, let alone a president in Washington, you must support Israel 100%, literally no matter what they do, right? And so they think, well, I don't get it, I'm applying the formula. I don't understand, I'm applying the formula. Whatever Israel says, I kiss their ass and I do it. Why isn't it working anymore? Well, here's why it's not working. Because in the past, the mainstream media was the only game in town. So they would repeat the same exact thing, and corporate Republicans and corporate Democrats who all take money from AIPAC and the defense industry would all repeat the same thing. And it was brainwashing on a mass scale. But because of social media, that's not working anymore. And they don't know how to adjust. It's not like they would ever care about human beings. They're just trying to figure out how to do the right marketing here, and they're failing abysmally at that too. But Anna, what I didn't expect is a turn on the right wing. And now I am seeing it all over the place where the right wing base is going, no, we don't support Israel anymore either. And I don't know why we're funding this, whether we like or don't like what Israel's doing, I don't want to fund it. And so I don't think that Israel has any idea how much trouble they're in when it comes to both the Democratic and the Republican base here in America. And Netanyahu has done untold damage. There's no way Hamas could have gotten us to not financially support Israel, but now it looks like Netanyahu has.
Yeah, it's interesting that you bring up the right wing, because look, over the last several years, there has been a growing portion of the Republican base who are self-identified isolationists. It's not that they're so much against Israel necessarily, it's that they want to focus on using American resources on the American people. But I will say that the tone of their critiques has also changed a little bit in recent weeks, because as we see more and more footage coming out of Gaza, as you see the complete and utter destruction of the infrastructure there, the ever increasing death toll, the attempts to silence people who are critical of Israel's far right government and how the IDF is carrying out their military operations. These are all things that are starting to offend the sensitivities of conservatives, some conservatives, and what their principles are. And so I'm honestly happy to see that, among that group, they're not just all talk, they walk the walk and they're speaking out. And, if there's an area where the left and the right can actually form a coalition on this one issue and apply pressure toward the United States government to take a different direction, I think that would be a good thing. Now, I want to get to one more video of Enten describing the outcome of that Wall Street Journal poll, because in the next clip, the discussion is really about independent voters who lean Democratic. What is the impact of this war on Gaza for those voters? Let's watch.
If you like Biden's handling of the Israel-Hamas war, look here, Joe Biden 94%, Donald Trump 2%. That's about what you'd expect to see, right? A very large lead for the Democratic candidate. Maybe just a few Democratic voters going the other direction. But take a look here. If you dislike Biden on the Israel-Hamas war, look, Joe Biden's still getting the lion's share of these voters at 81%. But this is a significant chunk of Democratic voters who are going in the other direction, 15%. So what essentially we're looking at here is a 66-point margin versus, look here, a 92-point margin.
You can't be losing 15% of Democrats if you're Joe Biden.
You cannot be doing that. This type of base going in the other direction is something you can have, especially if you have independents who are also turning against Joe.
Look, I think that that data is so critical to analyze and talk about, because we all know that the general election really comes down to those independent voters, right? I mean, if you are firmly a Democrat or if you're firmly a Republican, chances are you're going to play ball once it comes to the general and you're going to vote for your candidate or for the candidate in your party because you're a team player and you're going to support your tribe. Independent voters don't operate that way. And when you consider how the Electoral College works, Cenk, and when you consider the fact that Biden barely eked out a win in some of these swing states in 2020, these independent voters really could make all the difference when it comes to those critical battleground states.
Yeah, so he's doing even worse with those independent voters. But remember, that's not 15% of independent voters. That's not 15% of Democrats saying they're concerned about Biden's position. That's not 15% of Democrats saying they're gonna sit out the election, which would already be a disaster. That's 15% of Democrats saying they're gonna vote for Trump over Biden because of Biden's position on Israel and Gaza. You know what that means? That means this election's already over. So, I mean, if it were held today, obviously. So Joe Biden can turn around, although I doubt it. I would be floored if Joe Biden cut Israel's funding. We'll come back to that. Because turning around isn't, oh my God, you'll never believe what mean words I used on him on the phone. I wouldn't even call him daddy anymore. Okay, now no one cares. No one cares about what words you used. Only idiot cable news anchors care. And maybe if you work at the New York Times. But the rest of us are so tired of your blah, 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 blah. Money talks, BS walks, okay? You either cut the funding or just shut up already because you're humiliating yourself. I want to say one more thing about the right-wing voters too, because all of this is going in the direction of Biden almost definitely losing this election. But it has ramifications past the election too, because a good example is the Patrick Bet David show. Anna, you were on there, you were one of the first people that said on that show, which is right-wing, hey, I don't think what Israel's doing is right. And they started to be receptive to what you were saying in a way that was surprising. And then after you left, they wavered on it a lot and they would fall back into Israeli talking points, etc. But now recently they're saying, no, no, I don't see why we're funding this. This is crazy. And Biden looks so pathetically weak. He's just following Israel's orders. And they're beginning to put a little bit of pressure, I feel like, on Trump not to do likewise. So Biden's election is in danger. But Israel losing the support of America, period, is for the first time in my life an actual possibility.
Yeah, and look, I was shocked at the Patrick Bet David podcast's audience and how receptive they were to what I was saying in my critical statements about Israel and how they're carrying out this war. Because I thought they were gonna skewer me. I thought they were gonna hate those comments and they pretty much hated the rest of the interview, but they appeared to really appreciate what I had to say about how Israel was carrying out that war. And to me, that was the first sign that there really is a growing portion of the Republican base that really sees what's happening and they're not supportive of it. And they do not believe that American taxpayers should be funding, you know, the brutal annihilation of Palestinians in Gaza. But, you know, despite all of this data that's been coming out, Cenk, despite the multiple polls now showing Biden losing in battleground states, it appears that there's still this sense of denial within the Biden camp, even within the Biden household, as you're about to see in the next video.
So it's not a part of you that's a little worried, because you seem to be off kilter a little bit.
No, I feel that Joe will be reelected.
But when these polls, like the Wall Street Journal one, land in the White House and he's losing in all the battleground states.
No, he's not losing in all the battleground states. He's coming up and he's even or doing better. So you know what? Once people start to focus in and they see their two choices, it's obvious that Joe will win this election. Right.
Now, look, I should be fair. Dr. Jill Biden, the first lady, apparently behind the scenes is really urging Biden to end this war in Gaza. But in general, I gotta say, don't be delusional about what the polls are saying. And if you are, then your husband's gonna think he's doing everything correctly and he's not going to change course. And in fact, so far he hasn't changed course. And so I don't think it's really helpful to deny what the polls have been saying, really one after another saying the same thing, especially when it comes to the battleground states.
Yeah, so I don't believe her, and I'll come back to that in a second in terms of what she theoretically says about Israel. But to your point, Anna, about the polling, look, I think that she is actually representative of a lot of establishment thinking. They all think that it's obvious that Biden's gonna win. That is why a lot of times you'll see framing on articles or from cable news hosts where they'll say, shocking poll, Biden beginning to lose or trail a little bit. Is it even possible that he could lose? What the hell are you guys talking about? He's been losing in every poll for the last 6 months. They live in crazy la la land where they think the establishment Democrat is always going to win. That's super obvious because almost everyone in Washington and everyone in media is establishment Democrats or establishment Republicans. They all have the same group thing. So she's like, oh, it's so obvious. And then the second thing that she says there is once the American people realize these are their two choices, then obviously they're gonna vote for Biden. I've heard that. You might think that's the dumbest thing in the world. But we all realize that now. Do you think that people don't know that it's Trump versus Biden? But yes, these morons inside Washington really think, oh, people aren't paying attention yet. They don't even know who the candidates are. Once they find out it's Donald Trump, and once they know they have 91 indictments against him, or 91 counts against him, oh, then Biden's gonna win easily. You guys are in la-la land, lunatics, totally detached from reality. He's getting his ass handed to him. At this point, it's fairly obvious he's going to lose, not win.
Yeah, I mean, look, implied in that statement is really the notion that they're just going to scold their way to re-election, right? How could you say you're not going to cast a ballot for Joe Biden? He's the decent one. Again, real difficult to argue that Biden's the decent one as he provides the military weaponry for the slaughter of innocent Palestinian civilians in Gaza. We're not buying the argument that this is to fight Hamas. Obviously, the death toll of innocent civilians has overwhelmed the alleged death toll of Hamas militants. We don't even have an exact figure of Hamas militants who have been killed because Israel has been labeling every, you know, military age male in Gaza who's been killed as a Hamas militant, even though there's no evidence to prove that for many of them.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.